I want to twist your mind a bit today. I was just reading a certain article in the Citizen TV, I think a blog, whereby they showed a certain lady who pulled out her two children from school, and she said, "You see, school is, you know, it's satanic and all those kind of things." And many people are really wondering and asking, is she justified in what she says, that school is satanic and things like that? Now, I want to give just a general comment, which is biblical as well. I like to explain something. You see, our bodies are the temple of God, and everything that we have, it's all supposed to be for the working of the things of God. We should give our bodies as a living sacrifice to God and things like that. So one thing I like to explain is that school is not bad, but it all depends on what you're learning. You see, there are many people who take their schools, their children to school, but when they go there, they go to learn, you know, they're going to be brainwashed in some things. You go and, first of all, back in the days, we used to be taught things of God. We could pray before we start our lessons. There was a PPI, the time that we could sing and pray and, you know, hear the word of God before we start. Even everywhere in the whole entire world. But now, I don't know if you have realized that lately, things have changed. People are changing the strategy, and even schools are changing the way they operate. And the things which are being taught today to children, it's most of them are against God. Look at evolution. Children are being forced into understanding evolution, that the world came from, you see, a Big Bang theory and things like that. And you're forced. And if you don't agree to this, you're told that, you know, you're in denial, or you're foolish, or they call you a rebel and things like that. And likewise, have you ever realized most of the things that we study in school, we hardly even apply in our lives? Forget colleges and universities. That's a bit different, because at least you will learn some few things that you can apply in your life. But in the whole course of primary and high school education, we will learn a lot of obsolete things. How to dissect grasshoppers, how to do this and this. Things which is basically just a waste of time and waste of money. And I'm not saying education is not bad. Don't get me wrong. It's bad. Don't get me wrong. What I'm trying to say is you should be mindful and very careful on where you take your children to school, because there's a lot of brainwashing. There's a lot of things which your children are being taught there. Others, you see, they are taught how to respect LGBTs. You see, you can choose whichever gender you want, and your teacher can tell you nothing. And you see, you have rights of this, rights of that. Before we used, the Bible says, a parent should cane the child, you see, spare the rod and spoil the child. But now the government is saying, no, there are rights in the school that, you see, a child has some rights. You cannot cane a child, you cannot do this. You see, in some way or another, the world system is basically defying God, and is trying to put everything which is opposite so that they can instill it so much. Back in the days, children used to, if it's going to school and they come back home and they can stay with their parents, and their parents, their fathers can teach them how to go to the farm and do this and that and milk cows and do many other things. And they were taught by their parents on how to live and what to do. And also the girls were taught by their mothers on the good morals and how to become great wives and the things that they're supposed to do. But when you look at today's morality, people are being changed. And children are being taken to boarding schools. And you see, this notion that the boarding school is better than the day school, so that they want to stay with their child there, and they can indoctrinate your child fully into things that you cannot even imagine. Look at most of the children when they go to schools. Those are the places they discover how to, you know, keep on abusing other people. Most of the people you find that they started taking drugs in schools. I've had a very close relative of mine who, after he went to school, that is where they found, weed being smoked there, even hard drugs, even heroin, they're being used in schools. And when a child says, okay, from our home we don't do this, we're from a Christian family, he's being seen as if this is just, this guy doesn't understand, this boy, he's pretending, you see, he's fake, and all those kind of things. So you find that there's a lot of manipulation in the schools, and even in the colleges is the same way. How many people do you have outside here who have degrees and who have so many things, degrees, papers, masters, and all that, and they don't even have a job? And you see, the world is brainwashing people that you should work and get a good job, work and get a good job. Study very well and get a good job, high-paying job. Now, who are these job creators? We should ask ourselves, who are these job creators? We should understand that this is a system which is being created so that people can crowd in the cities. They can sit in the cities and just when they are there, all that they can think about is getting jobs and following the system and doing the things the way the system wants them to be done. Because the old fashion of life is like it's fading away. Now, look at in the big cities like Nairobi, Mombasa, and New York, and all the other places. People are crowding there. They want to search for jobs in those cities and places like that, and they are living very miserable lives, and they are hustling, and it's like hand to mouth a kind of a business. Why else they have left the villages, vast and vast pieces of land where nobody's cultivating, nobody's doing anything. People are crowding in one place. Why? Because the system tells you need to study, go to the cities, and find a job. So when you're crowded in one place, what happens? Confusion creeps in, and the manipulation creeps in, and people come in with their own values and come in with their own ideas, and they want to brainwash you in things that you cannot even understand, and even you can't have time with your children. So the children are being raised by the society. They're being raised by evil people, and they'll end up being like them. They have evil neighbors, for example, because people live in apartments. You stay downstairs, somebody lives upstairs, another one on the side, and you see, that's, I don't think that's how God created humanity to be, but we've been brainwashed by the satanic system so that we can agree to their ideologies. And look at how much someone spends in the university. You take your child to the university. By the time this child gets a degree, you've spent almost 400,000 Kenya shillings. By the time the child gets a master's, because a degree has no job nowadays, you'll spend another maybe 200,000 to 300,000 on top. By the time the child gets a PhD, you'll spend more than a million plus. I'm saying even on the lower side. Now think about it. If you took that 1 million shillings and went and helped your child to start to buy a farm and maybe put in some cattle and start cultivating or doing some jobs, even if you help them to start a job, they would be very far with that money. But now they will just get a piece of paper and now start struggling, going up and down looking for money, looking for employment where they'll be paid maybe 20, 30,000, 100,000, which cannot really help them because the demand of life is very high. Paying bills, paying rent, food, and all those things, you don't even know where to start. You see how the world system is brainwashing people? And everybody thinks this is the way to go. Now tell me, Abraham and Isaac and Jacob and other people, where did they go to school? Did they live? Did they eat? Did they enjoy life? People will say, oh, those were the old days. Yeah, they were the old days, but they were living. They had a good life. They were not brainwashed, and they were not all living in one place like the way we do nowadays. So we need to open our eyes also as we figure out on how to live our lives in the modern way. Let's try and avoid the system, because if you don't avoid the system as much as you can, it will brainwash you into just being like them. And the end result is going to be the new world order, new one world religion, one world currency. Everything will all be controlled. And you will be there, you'll not be understanding, am I going north or south? That's the only way I can say. So, anyway, brothers and sisters, today I just thought of giving an idea about the education system and how it entails and what really happens. But all in all, remember to believe the gospel. The gospel is found in 1 Corinthians 15, 1 through 4, and is all about how that Christ died for our sins, was buried, and rose again the third day, according to the scriptures. That's the gospel. If you believe the gospel, you shall be saved. Thank you.